discuss the electrical drive system. In this electrical drive system, yesterday we had been seen a lot of explanation for the electrical drive system. Electrical drive system is motion control is required in large number of industrial and domestic applications, like transportation, then rolling mills, paper machines, textile mills, machine tools, fans, pumps, and robot washing machine. So these all our applications are under the control of this drive system. Okay, this is application and industrial working condition of electrical drive system. Always system employed for motion control, which is called drive. I mentioned earlier. Okay, we have to justify. May employ any of prime mover such as diesel or petrol engine or gas or steam turbine, steam engines, hydraulic motors and hydraulic power handling motors. So all motors for supplying mechanical energy for motion control. So drive motors, especially in the categories, electric motor are known as electrical drive. So it has some classification according of modes of operation. We have three classification. One is continuous duty. Continuous duty cycle means the motor working continuously from the starting position to ending position without any interruption of external disturbances or internal disturbances. This is continuous duty cycle. Second one is discontinuous duty cycle. Discontinuous duty cycle in the sense, while the motor gets starts from our indication, the motor will be running with some interruptions of internal and external disturbances. That will be called discontinuous. Third one is intermittent or short time. Short time duty means whether we had been allocated some of the time to work done for that motor with short period. Short period in the sense 1 hour the motor will be working their working function, but the motor will get to start a start time. Okay, this is will be called as a short time duty cycle. Then according their representation of controlling, we have to classify three. One is manual, semi-automatic, automatic. Manual in the sense, one man handled that electrical drive system or electrical drive system motor, which mean manual. Automatic in the sense, without human being interruption, the machine or motor or any kind of electrical component system working their allocated representation, which is meant by automatic. Semi-automatic means so the electrical drive system partially controlled by machine or partially controlled by humans. So that category will be called as a semi-automatic. So those three categories are controlled categories. Then according to number of machine, so machine in the sense I called a motor. The motor always act as a machine. When the motor receive electrical energy converted into mechanical energy, the machine act as a motor, or the machine when the machine receive the mechanical energy which is converted into electrical energy, it will be act as a load. So always we call a machine. The machine inputs depends upon whether this machine motor or load. Okay, the inputs are defined that machine as a motor or load. So a representation of that calculation, number of machines having individual drive, group drive, and multimotor drive. Okay, so those three categories of drive may and may not describe the transient period of controlled and uncontrolled cases. Okay, then the speed control having three methods. One is reversible and non-reversible uncontrolled constant speed, reversible and non-reversible step speed control, variable position control. So those three categories are we discussed earlier or yesterday classes, so no need to explain again and again. Now we watch types of loads. Types of loads also we discussed. So then we move on steady state stability. The steady state stability having two state, one is equilibrium state, another one is unequilibrium or unstable point. So steady state stability shows concept wise equilibrium in the sense when motor torque always equals to load torque. This category mean by steady state stability of equilibrium point. Otherwise, when the motor torque not equal to load torque, which is called unequilibrium steady state stability. So those two categories are very important while the motor running for producing the drive categories, which is very very important. So this is steady state stability graph. Already I said a stable state of equilibrium point shows in first graph. Unstable state, just a minute, Arun Kumar coming. Yeah, Arun Kumar, இவ்வளவு லேட்டா வரீங்க? நீங்க தான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வருவீங்க எப்போதும். பட் ரெண்டு தடவை ஜாயின்ட் ஆயிருக்கீங்க, என்ன பிரசன்ட் கொடுக்குறீங்களா அருண்? என்ன ஏற்கனவே இருக்கிறீங்க, இப்பயும் உள்ள வரீங்க, ரெண்டு ஐடி இருக்கா உங்களுக்கு, ஏன் இவ்வளவு லேட்டா வரீங்க? ஓ, ஒர்க் போக கிளாஸ் அட்டன் பண்ணிக்கலாம் அப்படின்ட்டு வெயிட் பண்றீங்களா? என்னன்னு we have to discuss steady state stability. Steady state stability having two classification, one is equilibrium and non-equilibrium. Okay, that two classification represent these two graphs. Okay, now apart from that explanation, apart from that graph, we have to discuss mathematical condition for the stability of the equilibrium point. So what I'm saying, throughout the electrical drive categories of steady state stability always having two torque classifications. One is motor torque, another one is load torque. Those two torques are always equal, means that will be called as a steady state equilibrium state. That two motor torque always being in opposite mean, that will be called as an unequilibrium state. Okay, so first we have to meet out the first condition. The first condition is when the motor torque is equal to load torque. That means motor torque represent T suffix E, load torque represent T suffix L. So those two torques equal in the sense steady state equilibrium. Oh, from that condition we have to make one mathematical equation. So TE equal to TL, that TE equal to TL can convey or can formulate the model of differentiation. Okay, so under the differentiation condition, TE can change DTE by d omega with representation of angular velocity. Okay, so dte by d omega equal to dTL by d omega. This is under equilibrium condition of differentiation form. Okay, we have two modes of form. One is equate the equilibrium state, that will be called as a steady state equilibrium state. In mathematical wise, TE equal to TL. That TE equal to TL can have to convert the differentiation form. That differentiation form is dTE by d omega equal to dTL by d omega. Okay, these two categories of torque always greater than that of zero. Okay, so shall we move on? Four quadrant operation of a drive. Four quadrant operation coming from the motor operation and the load variations depending upon the motor operation. Okay, those two categories can exhibit their quadrant operation. Quadrant having four classification: first quadrant or starting, second quadrant or acceleration, third quadrant or deceleration, fourth quadrant or stopping. So those four categories of quadrant can make their motor operation in order to the good form or unequilibrium form. This is quadrant, four quadrant operation. So here you look at that first picture. In that first quadrant having angular velocity and TE in the sense motor torque, and the motor torque, angular velocity, both direction are same, anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so the direction mentioned, those two categories are rotate in anti-clockwise. Okay, second quadrant, angular velocity and electrical torque or motor torque. Motor torque is forward direction or clockwise direction. Angular velocity is anti-clockwise or reverse direction of that electrical motor. This is deceleration or opposite of load torque. Third quadrant is motor torque, forward direction, angular velocity is same direction. So this will be produce a very good electrical motor categories and very well output of their representation. Fourth quadrant is anti-clockwise of electrical motor, clockwise of angular velocity. This representation mean by, if some mishaps in the electrical motor drive categories, so those four quadrant of operation mentioned simply and shortly of four quadrant operation of drive under the table conditions. So I have to read this function: first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. So it has different operations. So that operation mentioned by operation of the host. So it has some features. That features are electrical motor torque, load torque, angular velocity, maximum angular velocity, power production and operation of the drive. Okay, so first, in first quadrant, operation of the host having the hoisting. Hoisting means, don't confuse the word hoisting. Hoisting means capable or equilibrium of angular velocity and torque. Okay, both the directions or both the wavelength can manage their position of representation, which is called hoist. Don't confuse this word hoist. Okay, in first quadrant, already I told you all, the hoist up to the loaded cage. Loaded cage means, if you had to assume, you all have to assume, you just kept one kind of example for this hoist. You just lift up 10 kg of weight in your left hand, same 10 kg of weight in right hand. Okay, both hands are encased by lifting some of the weight, equal weight of 10 kg. Okay, so now what you feel about those two weights, equal weights, those two equal weights were to be lift in your two hands. Okay, sometime you extend your lifting, but in a certain period you just can't weight in a differentiation with your both hands. Which hand for equal and the opposite reaction of hands capability. This is concept of hoist. Don't confuse this word, concept of hoist. Okay. First quadrant having loaded cage, second quadrant having unloaded cage, third quadrant having motion, downwards motion of the unloaded cage, fourth quadrant having downward motion of the loaded cage. Okay, those four categories are different. Okay, then first one is electrical torque and load torque, angular velocity, power, operation of the drive. Okay, this electrical torque in first quadrant is positive, second quadrant is negative, third quadrant is negative, fourth quadrant is negative. Then load torque is first quadrant is negative, second quadrant is positive, third quadrant is positive, fourth quadrant is negative. So same like angular velocity is first quadrant positive, second quadrant positive, third quadrant negative, fourth quadrant negative. By the way of power, first quadrant positive, second quadrant negative, third quadrant positive, fourth quadrant negative. Operation of the drive, always first quadrant is forward motoring, second quadrant is forward braking, third quadrant is reverse motoring, fourth quadrant is reverse braking.